SpaceX preparing for Starship launch. Falcon 9 and Starlink updates.
Hello everyone, welcome back. Here is our new episode with latest SpaceX and space news. So, let's get started.
First, we will start off with Starship Super Heavy developmental updates, because there has been a lot of progress happening at the SpaceX's Starbase facility last week, but not with the legal side. I hope you got it. Yes, the US Fish and Wildlife officials hadn't made much progress in reviewing SpaceX's upgrades after Starship's first launch in April. Elon Musk was quite vocal about his frustration with this delay. However, things started looking more positive as days rolled on. The hot staging ring on Booster 9 was removed, but it wasn't because there was something wrong with it. It was removed to provide access to the top of Booster 9. Underneath the hot staging segment, there's a lot of hardware, so SpaceX wanted to address this in some way. They put scaffolding in place for workers to access the booster's top. Later on, Tuesday, the hot stage ring was lifted by a crane, raised up, and then restacked on top of Booster 9. This was a significant development that added to the excitement. The excitement continued to ramp up on Wednesday as a contraption called Chopsticks grasped Ship 25 by its lifting points and raised it to the top of Booster 9. Then, it was swung over for restacking on the rocket. Keep in mind that this won't be the last time we see Ship 25 stacked and restacked because it hasn't had its flight determination system armed yet. However, we might expect to see a full stack test, like a wet dress rehearsal, in the coming days or weeks. This is a crucial step in preparing for the orbital flight. Construction at the Starship Factory building continued. Crews were busy adding external white cloud to the building, which is part of the ongoing work to make the factory a hub for Starship production and assembly. There was an interesting development when the AFT, aft dome bulkhead, section, which belonged to the now-scrapped Ship 27, was rolled out into the ring yard. This section was then transported down to the Massey's test site. It was quite an operation. Once at the test site, it was lifted into what's called the structural test cage. While it's not entirely clear what test SpaceX plans to subject this test article to, it's a significant part of Starship development. Another test tank, known as Ship 24.2, was rolled out to the build yard. This was in preparation for its move to the Massey's test site. This move eventually happened on Friday night. At the Massey's site, cryo testing of Ship 29 took place, not once but twice last week. Cryo testing is essential as it helps ensure the integrity of the spacecraft when exposed to the extreme temperatures of space. It's one of the critical steps before any actual flights can happen. Some leaked photos surfaced on the internet that gave us new views of the crater left by Booster 7 during the Starship orbital flight test. This event has been covered extensively because it's a stark reminder of the immense power of those Raptor engines and the colossal scale of operations at Starbase. Sometimes, it's hard to grasp how massive everything is at Starbase because there's nothing nearby to provide a sense of scale. Before we move on, let's take a moment to appreciate SpaceX's history. Recently, SpaceX celebrated the 15-year anniversary of Falcon 1, SpaceX's very first orbital launch vehicle. It's essential to understand this milestone because Falcon 1 paved the way for SpaceX's future success. Falcon 1's story is quite remarkable. It didn't have an easy start. In fact, it failed on its first three missions. If the fourth mission didn't succeed, SpaceX might not be here today. But thankfully, Falcon 1's fourth mission was a success. It reached Earth orbit, becoming the first privately developed liquid-fueled rocket to do so. This marked a turning point in SpaceX's journey and laid the foundation for the legendary Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets. Speaking of Falcon 9, SpaceX recently launched the Starlink Group 6 to 18 mission from Cape Canaveral. It's incredible to see these rockets in action, and they're becoming quite reliable. The first stage of the Falcon 9 landed successfully on the "Of Course I Still Love You" drone ship in the Atlantic Ocean. What's notable here is that this landing marked the 10th successful landing for this particular booster, known as B1069. It's a testament to the reusability of SpaceX's rockets, which is a game changer for space exploration. Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy are currently the only SpaceX rockets in operation. However, they wouldn't exist without Falcon 1. So that's all about today's episode. See you tomorrow, and until then, goodbye.